Hey guys, and it is 2017 and it feels good to be back. I haven't recorded a video for 2 weeks and a half, I believe, apart from my vlog, which I will link below. It's just the previous video, so you can go ahead and check that out. There will be a couple of changes to our channel. You may have noticed already and will start to appear now and then. As you know, last year I changed the intro and the outro to our YouTube channel videos. And now what I've started to do is change our social media account names to give it a more accessible and ease for you to contact us. I mean, it is a bit confusing with my Snapchat and Instagram and Twitter all having different handle names because they are basically our social names that we've had for years. But now we've both felt that it's a good time to change them so they are easier for you guys. Also coming to the YouTube channel will be a kind of scheduled uploading of videos. So January is not going to count so much because we've just had Christmas. So this is the what I got for Christmas and what I bought on Boxing Day, or in the sales, let's just say that. And then just after that was my birthday, so I'll be doing a video for that. And then it's going to go a bit more organised. I really want to organise our YouTube channel so you know what's coming and you know kind of what videos to expect. So there will be a couple of challenges each month, there will be either favourites each month, and then there will be like a haul video. I just don't want it to be haul, 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 haul. I want it to be varietised, shall we say. I want there to be different videos in there. I am going to be doing some requested videos that you guys have requested during last year. But if there's anything that you can think of that you would love to see on our channel, please do let us know either through Twitter, Instagram, social media, comment section below, whatever. I think I've said enough. Let's just get into this video. So as you guys know, it has just been Christmas. I've been so excited for the Christmas season to come around and for Christmas Day to come around especially. It is one of my favourite, in fact, it is my favourite celebration, seasonal celebration. It's just, I love Christmas, and my sister does too. So if she was here, she'd be saying the same thing as me right now. So firstly, I'm going to start off with the family videos, which are slipping off my lap. But the first DVD is The Legend of Tarzan. I absolutely love this film. I went to see it in the cinema with my family, and I'm just so glad we have it on DVD. Next we have is Finding Dory, which I absolutely adore. If you haven't seen this film, you have to go see it, especially if you've seen the first one, Finding Nemo. I just love how these two films are tied together with Dory's past and how she got the Just Keep Swimming song, and just everything about this ties the two films together, and I love it. I just love Dory, and yeah. Next we have The Suicide Squad. Now this is one film that I was most anticipated for 2016, especially since my sister wasn't going to see it and I know how much she loves Harley Quinn. I have to say, I cannot wait for my sister to see this. It's not the best film compared to like the Batman. It's just a really good, I think if you like humour and you like superheroes and you like the bad guys, you're gonna love this film, and I absolutely love it, and I'm so glad I got it for Christmas. Now this next present I actually didn't get for Christmas, my mum did. I'm not sure who she got it from, but she wasn't so keen on it, she didn't know what she was going to use it for. However, she gave it to me and I absolutely adore it. It is this cute snack bowl in the shape of a Christmas tree. Next I'm just going to try and get all of the edible presents out of the way because there is such a huge amount, probably more than last year. Or about the same as last year, I cannot remember. So this was from my auntie and uncle, and it says, "To Katie, Merry Christmas, love, Uncle Graham, Auntie Angela, Adam and Nathan." And they just give me and my brother a bag full of tubes of sweets and chocolates. So I have eaten, I think, at least two of these tubes, I can't remember. Let's see. Yeah, that one's gone. So one jelly top, a second lot of jelly tots which I haven't eaten yet, Pick a Mix, Round Trees. I just love Round Trees sweets in general, I do, and I think Pick a Mix is a great idea, and just a little mix of all of their sweets in general. Fruit Pastel tube, which is all gone. I still have two boxes tubes of Minstrels, which Galaxy is like my favourite chocolate. I think if you watched my Christmas video last year, I'm pretty sure I got Galaxy in that one. But I just love Galaxy chocolate. It's
It's just heaven.
I also got another tube of fruit pastels from my other uncle. Actually, no, this was from my cousin. These were from my cousin, Natasha, Daniel, and Hiram. They gave me a tube of fruit pastels, which has been eaten. So I can go in the bin. Next up, I have this giant bar of Galaxy. Oh yes, I haven't even tucked into this yet, but I think I might do after this video. Then again, I might keep it longer as my Galaxy stash. Katie Ellis loves to have a Galaxy chocolate stash, or even just a chocolate stash. This is a stash and a half. Yeah. My dad got me some Reese's Pieces. My brother also got one of these as well. He opened his first and I was like, oh, well now I know what that present is. I love peanut butter. I love chocolate, but Reese's is the second thing to Galaxy, I think. Just peanut butter and chocolate. It's just a winning combination. The next thing my dad also got, edible-wise, was this little guy. This is the Reese's Peanut Butter Snowman, and I cannot wait to eat this guy. But I really savor these for a long time because I just can't bring myself to tear him to shreds and just eat his goodness. It'll probably be the last thing I eat, let's face that. Celebration box. I actually swapped these with my mum. I got a little packet of Thorntons from Courtney, which I do love, but most of them, like nuts and coffee and other things in the little packet, I wasn't too keen on. My mum loves Thorntons and I just love celebrations. And you've got Maltesers in there, Milky Way, Mars, my favourites. Bounties I'm not going to eat because I don't like coconut, but the rest I'm gonna be munching on those. Also from Courtney, I got a medium-sized bar of Galaxy. This has just been edible Christmas. I mean, every time someone opens something that's edible, that's a Christmas present, we just call it an edible Christmas. My mum got so much edible presents, it was unbelievable. I think most of her presents were fudge. I think that's all the edible left. Talking of Courtney, I will now show you what Courtney got me. And oh my goodness, I did not expect my friend Courtney to get me this much stuff. Like, I sent her this cute little package full of like 4 to 5 items. It might have been 4. I got this big parcel through the post wrapped in wrapping paper with my address on it. And I forgot who was sending me gifts until I was like, oh, I know who that might be from. It might be from Courtney. I asked her and she was like, yes, you can open it because the presents inside were individually wrapped. But I didn't want to wreck the wrapping paper, so I just had it as one big present on Christmas Day. When I came to it and I opened it, I could not believe how many things she'd wrapped and how many things she'd got me in this cute little hamper of a parcel. Like, seriously? Thank you so much, Courtney. The first thing I'm going to show you is something that Courtney wasn't so sure about getting me, mainly to do with the fragrance, because this is peppermint. And I do like peppermint, but I prefer spearmint. This is the Peppermint Cooling Foot Lotion, and this actually smells quite nice. It's not too strong, whereas these two little items, they're from Body Shop, by the way. We've got the Peppermint Smoothing Pumice Foot Scrub and the Peppermint Reviving Foot Soak. Now, I've never used foot products before. I've never really thought to care for my feet. Like, I care for the rest of my body, but I kind of just moisturize my feet when I moisturize my body, but I've never really thought about focusing just on my feet. However, I'm not sure I'm going to be using these. I've already spoke to Courtney and said I'm not sure I can use this, but this is peppermint and it's just so strong. It reminds me of some kind of like medicine. It hits the back of my throat and it just makes me feel a bit queasy. I'm not sure. Some people will like this, but I know my dad will absolutely love this and he says he'll take it off my hands. I think Courtney knows how much I love bath fizzes and bath bombs because she went and picked me up this Leafy and Lovely Summer Meadow Bath Fizzer Tablet. Now, you can just about smell the fragrance and it's quite nice. It's kind of like a floral fragrance, but it just says unwrap and place in a warm bath, wait for the fizzer to dissolve, lie back and relax, avoid storing in direct sunlight. But it doesn't really say what it smells of, but it smells good. Kind of smells a bit lavendery and lemony, something like that, I don't know. This though, oh my gosh, I've actually seen this brand in Superdrug, and that's probably where she got it from, but Flutter Body Scrub. This smells freaking amazing. I've never bought anything from the brand Flutter. Like, I've seen it so much in Superdrug, And how cute is this packaging? It's like this rose gold lid with this kind of pink, black and white label. But anyway, it's a bit gooey, but it smells so good. But it's like, I think it smells strawberry, like a sweet strawberry, milky fragrance. I'm terrible at describing fragrances. So good. I love this, Courtney. Good job. Last two things from Courtney. We have this gorgeous Revolution Strobe Highlight, and this is kind of like, I think it's like a pinky lilac highlight. And well done, Katie, there's tape on this, so you cannot get your hands into this. But it's kind of this watery water print. I don't know, I mean, what do you call that? But it's a baked highlighter. Ooh, no, actually. See, now in the pan, it looks kind of pinky purpley. I'm not sure if you can even see that, but it's like a pinky purpley. But when I swatch it, it's a really natural highlight. I thought it'd be a bit more purple, which I'm glad it's not, because I don't really like purple highlights. This is nice. Ooh, I might, yeah. Yeah, man. The last thing Courtney got, I am over the freaking moon with. Now, a couple of months ago, Courtney went to Disneyland Paris, and I haven't been there since I was, say, 13? Maybe younger than that. 10, 11, maybe? And I never picked this up, what she bought me. I never thought, my little naive self, to get some freaking mini ears. Oh my gosh. I have been dying to get my very own pair of mini ears for years. I absolutely love these, and to open this on Christmas Day made me so emotional, because it's just such a thoughtful present. And I did say to her when she got her pair, when she went, I was like, I would absolutely love a pair of those. I'm just so glad she got me a pair. It means so much, and they're just so freaking adorable. I love them, and I cannot wait to wear them whenever I want. Next present is from my friend Liesl, and this Pokemon name tag was wrapped separately to this little guy. And I was like, what the heck could be in this? And it's a little Minun or Minun. I don't know how to pronounce that Pokemon's name. And it's just so cute. It's a little Pichu, but it's the Minun version, and the plusle is the positive one. And yeah, she knows I love Pokemon, and I just thought it was cute to get one of those. The next thing she got me was Hologram Effect nail polish in the shade Mermaid Spell, which is number 6, by the brand Layla. I think that's the brand anyway. And it's this kind of cool toned blue with so many sparkles in it. It is unfreaking believable. Woo! Nearly dropped that. My heart just skipped a beat. But I've never heard of this kind of nail polish brand before, and I'm really intrigued how this is gonna go on my nails. So as you guys know, I am on YouTube. That was a bit of a weird way to start this intro to this present. I do run out of battery sometimes, especially when recording lots of videos back to back. So my gran got me a new Nikon battery, which I'm so happy with, because when I'm recording one video, this one can be charging, or it'll already be charged. And then if my battery runs out, I can put this one in and I'll be good to go. I really needed a second battery. I'm so glad I got one for Christmas. Thank you. My best friend at work recently left, and her name was Fatima, and I was really kind of down and a bit sad that she left, but I was rooting for her to get a better job, a good job, and she's really happy as far as I know where she is. However, she thought to get me a Christmas present, and she doesn't really celebrate Christmas, so this is really nice of her to go out and do this. A couple of months before Christmas, they brought in these bad boys in Primark. And when I went to get one after work, because she knew I was eyeing it up, they had ran out of stock of them. They weren't getting any more in. I was fuming because there were so many at the beginning of the day, but I couldn't get my hands on one of these. A couple of days before Christmas, Fatima asked me to meet up with her, and she had bought me this as my Christmas present. And I didn't know what it was, because it was kind of like in this pink bag, gift bag. It wasn't wrapped, but I just thought she got me some cardboard, and then I saw it, and I started to tear up in the middle of town, and she was like, are you crying? And I was like, I am, just it's just so thoughtful, and I don't know, how did you get it? And she was like, oh, I went on the internet, I found it on eBay, and just picked it up for you because I know how much you loved it. And it's one of the most thoughtful presents a friend has ever thought to get me, especially when that person loves Harry Potter. I just freaking love it, and I cannot wait to put this on my wall. I'm so happy I got this, and I'm so thankful that it was from a friend that means so much to me. So thank you, Fatima, I really do love it. So the next few things are from my best friend. She picked up this little stocking filler, the two hand warmers, Mickey and Minnie. These are from Primark. We saw these and she also picked one up for herself. I was actually going to use these in London, but I forgot to bring them deliberately because I wanted to show you guys what they look like. And I can't wait to use them. A week before Christmas, I walked into Forbidden Planet and saw that Funko Pop had released Flounder as a Funko Pop. Now, I think I knew this was coming out, but had completely forgotten. And to go into Forbidden Planet and see it on the shelf, I stood there with my brother, because we were going Christmas shopping at the time. I stood there staring at it, and I was like, no freaking way. What? I think what I just love about this so much is the fact that it's Flounder on his own, whereas with other Funko Pops, you have the Disney princess with their sidekick next to them. But this, I love the fact that they've released Flounder on his own. I have Ariel, and it's just complete. I have Ariel in the blue dress, and then I have Flounder. It's still so cute. I really appreciate this so much, and I'm so thankful it's come from my best friend, and she knows how much I love Flounder. The final present from Katie that I got for Christmas, the Too Faced Melted Matte Lipstick in Cool Girl. I have been wanting this for so long. I'm so glad I finally have it. Again, thank you, Katie. It is the shade I'm wearing today. I absolutely love it. It feels like I'm not wearing anything, but I just love the shade. It's kind of like a mid-tone chocolatey brown with a bit of a mid-pink in it. And I just love these melted mattes. I absolutely adore them. Staying on the makeup theme, since I don't think I've ever got this much makeup for Christmas in a long time. I think the first Christmas I got makeup was literally last year. Before that, I never really got makeup for Christmas. I got the final eye palette that I've been needing in my Tanya Burr collection. This I received from Bethan. Thank you so much, Bethan, because it means I don't have to go hunt for it and try and find a really good one. This looks amazing. This is the one I was debating to get for so long because I was really scared of this Witch's Cat eyeshadow. It's a really matte black. The two shades I really wanted to try out of this palette was the Velvet Cushion. It's such a lovely brown neutral shade, and then Alohomora, which every Harry Potter girl, you're just gonna relate this to Harry Potter. I totally recommend Tanya Burr's eyeshadows 100%. They are just so good, so blendable, and so opaque. I love them. The next two things I got from Bethan were these two Tanya Burr lipsticks. I already have two. One in the shade Pink Cocoa, and then I think the other one is like a dark red, but I can't remember. What's the name of it? These two shades I have been wanting for quite some time. She asked me what other shades I would like, and I got the Wild Safari. And this one is Happily Ever After. The last makeup product. Yes, guys, this is the last item of makeup. So what I got for Christmas from my mum was this. Oh my goodness. I never got last year's, and I really wanted last year's. However, this year's seems a lot better, in my opinion. Like, the shades in this look so good. If you don't know what this is, guys, this is the Christmas in New York Grand Hotel Cafe by Too Faced. They are three eyeshadow palettes and a mascara. I'm going to open this so you can see what they look like. Oh my gosh, this is stuck. Please come out. Oops. So it comes like this. Look how cute this packaging is. It is freaking adorable. I do have the other palette in this range, but that's coming up in another video because I actually bought that myself. And it is just so adorable. It has a little roof which pops off like this. And then these two flaps open like the door to the hotel. This plastic bit comes off, and then inside here you have the mascara, which I'm not going to get out, I'm just going to leave in there, but that's the Better Than Sex mascara. And then these eyeshadow palettes pop out like that, and that's what the rest of the hotel looks like inside. absolutely adorable. I'm just gonna pop that over there. You get your three eyeshadow palettes like this, and then on the back of each one it says to and from, but it's just a nice idea because if you didn't want them all for yourself you can share them between your friends, but I'm not going to do that because I really like these and they're a Christmas present for me. So the first one we have here is the Too Faced Eggnog Latte. The good thing about these is that they're all compact, so you could just choose one of them and then take them on holiday or wherever. So you have the plastic film that comes with it, and then you have six eyeshadows and then a blush. It's so freaking pretty. Look at that middle shade, the glitter. So the first one we have is Frosty Nog Eggnog Latte, Iced Coffee, Skinny Latte, Cold Brew, Central Perk. Oh my gosh, I love that. Look how green that is. That's gorgeous. And then we have Peach Cobbler as the cheek there. Oh, and that smells so good. Peppermint. As you know, I'm not a fan of peppermint, but we'll see how this smells like. This is the Peppermint Mocha film. That can come off. Oh no, this is like a sweet peppermint. I like this. The shade you have here is this Peppermint Cream Christmas Blend, which is this kind of like soft gold. Peppermint Mocha, Candy Cane, Sprinkles, and Coffee Chip. I like the look of that shade. And then we have Santa Baby as the blush. And then the last one, which I'm so excited to smell because I love gingerbread. If you smelt the Zoella gingerbread range, it smells just like that. And that gold, oh my goodness, that has to be my best gold eyeshadow I own. First one we've got is Ginger Cream, Maple Syrup, Ginger Snap. I cannot wait to use that shade. Winter Dream, which is kind of like this lilac-y frosty shade. It's really nice. Cup of Joe. Scarlett, what did you do with Joe? Did you kill him and make him into an eyeshadow? Black Coffee, and then the, I guess this is bronzer, which I like this, it's called Ginger Red. Love this shade, I just love this palette as a whole. I do have to apologise how long this video is taking me. I am really sorry. The next present, which I am so chuffed about, is the Minnie Mouse Hooded Throw. These are available at Primark, and my best friend really wanted one. She'd seen it on Instagram, and it's the most clever and creative design of a throw ever. The fact that it has like pockets where you can put your hands in, like hand warmers, ow, just hit my elbow, and a hood, and it's Disney, and it's Minnie Mouse. It's just so snuggly and I can't wait to snuggle up in it. DVD wise, we're moving on. I got the Me Before You DVD. I love this movie. Absolutely love it. I still have not read the book, and I've heard that I should because it's just as good as the film, probably better. I got my mum and myself to watch it, not on Christmas Day, but a couple of days after. She wasn't so sure about it. She's like, oh, I hope it's not a lot of lovey-dovey, because she's not too fussed about lovey-doveys, but she cried and I cried, and she was just so thankful that she watched it. She absolutely loved it. Such a good film. If you haven't seen Me Before You, please go watch it. It might even make you rethink about how much your life and others mean to you. I love this. It's just so good. No surprise, because I get these every year, I got the Once Upon a Time 5th season. Just look at that cover. It looks amazing. And then I have the complete 7th season of The Vampire Diaries. Damon, you is my man crush, and he's so gorgeous. Look at his eyes. Some of you are like, ugh, but I absolutely love Damon, love Ian Somerhalder. Yes. Moving on to books. As you know, my sister's away in Barbados, and we were able to Skype her on Christmas Day, and I was so happy that I got to see her over the internet and see how happy she is and her face. I cannot wait for you guys, you new subscribers, to be able to see her when she comes back, because she half makes this channel, and I cannot wait to see how much this channel's grown and meet all you new guys, because It's her channel just as well as mine. Moving on. Normally at Christmas we have joint presents, and the joint present for me and my sister that I got to open over Skype was the third book in the Girl Online trilogy. This is the last book, and I guiltily haven't finished the second one or even the first one. Now, if you watch The Walking Dead, you will know what this is from, or where this is from, if you're that geeky-fied like me and my dad. What was the little book that Morgan has as his like little Bible as he carries around. It is this book. My dad got one for himself and one for me, and I read, there's like a little intro at the beginning, and it's basically the teachings of the founder of Aikido. You have like a little quote every day, and I just love the fact that it's something me and my dad both love, and it's just a little book that we have from The Walking Dead. I mean, genius. And when I'm feeling down, I can look in here and look at one of the quotes. I'm just gonna read one. Let's just go for this one. Master the divine techniques of the art of peace, and no enemy will dare to challenge you. I just think it's a cute little book and a very nice idea and stocking filler. Absolutely love this. The final book that I got for Christmas, it's The Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them, the original screenplay. The movie was amazing. And I seriously cannot wait for my sister to see this because I know how much she's gonna love it. I had tears in my eyes when I saw the Thunderbird for the very first time. The Thunderbird is my second favourite creature to the Thestrals, and I was just so happy to finally see it on screen and in kind of like real life. But I love this. I cannot wait to read this and continue and relive the movie. So excited to read this. That was from my uncle. Thank you. Thinking onto Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them, my brother got me Newt Scamander's scarf. Hell yes. I'm so over the moon with this. I've got like the Newt Scamander logo down here and I love it and I can't wait to wear it. Thank you so much, bro. My final Christmas present that was at the top of my list, and if you watched my Q&A videos, you will know that the top Christmas present I really wanted was the Deep Euphoria perfume by Calvin Klein. And not only did I get the 50ml, but I got the little 15ml as well. They come as a duo, and my dad, seriously, I'm so happy I've got this perfume. It's freaking amazing. So now we're gonna move on to December / Boxing Day / January sales, whatever you wanna call it. These were mainly bought in the last week of December, and some of these are repurchases because I just had to get them because the price of these products were seriously good. So the first thing I picked up were, again, the lip balms by Zoella, the gingerbread and vanilla lip balms. These things are amazing. I wanted to pick up a backup when my first ones run out so I can use these continually and never have to worry about trying to find them on eBay for extortionate prices. Again, Zoella, I picked up the Hungry Hands. I picked up two, so I have three in total. This hand cream smells so good. Not only does it have gingerbread in it, but it has cinnamon in it too. And I love Zoella's hand creams. And these were $1.99 each. I think the lip balms were $2.99, and I could not repurchase the perfume and body cream moisturizer set because this was $3.99, no, $4.99. Next, I went to Lush and picked up the Bubble Bar. The Candy Mountain Bubble Bar. I just had to. I could not go another few months coming out of the Christmas season not having a bath smelling of Snow Fairy. So White Bath Balm. It is one of my Christmas scents. I just had to pick another one of these up. I was even more happy to be able to pick up the two bubble bars that I wasn't able to pick up the first time because I just couldn't pull myself to spend money on any more Lush products. I was able to pick up the Christmas Penguin Bubble Bar and the Peeping Santa Bubble Bar. Lastly, I could not go another Christmas, talking about 2017 Christmas, without picking up the Festive Spice Luxury Rediffuser. Now my sister got me the one that I had on display in the background last Christmas, and I used it 2016 Christmas. Now I wanted to buy this because I can use it for 2017's Christmas, and it ran out really quickly, my last one, so I wanted one that had more in it. And this was originally £16, as you can see, on Boxing Day or a couple of days after Boxing Day. It'd gone down to £5, and I never knew Next did such great deals on their Christmas range, but now I do, so I'm gonna wait until Boxing Day and the sales after Christmas so I can get my Christmas diffusers for next year. And that is everything. I'm so appreciative of everything I've got for Christmas. I never underappreciate what I get. I just love everything. I love the thought process got into it. And seriously, I love my family, I love my friends, and even more for their creative thinking and what to get me. So yeah, that is it, guys. That is 2016's Christmas present what I got for Christmas video. Now we've just got to wait another 365 days or less till next Christmas, and Claire will be back by then, so I can't wait. That'll be my Christmas present, just Claire for Christmas, even though she'll be back at the end of November. But anyway, enough of me talking. I hope you had a wonderful Christmas, a wonderful new year, and I cannot wait to start this year of vlogging and videoing for our YouTube channel. That is the end of this video. If you liked it, please give this video a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel and comment below. And I will see you guys next time. Bye. So as you guys know, I cannot get my words out today. Really can't. So firstly, I'm gonna, falling off my lap now, are you? Running away. I do have the other palette. Don't fall on me. Better than Miss Sex.